Hello guys, welcome to another Laravel 6 tutorial. And today I would like us to learn how to authenticate users using Google. So we'll be using the package called Laravel package called Socialite, and then be able to authenticate users and log them in into our application. So what I would like us to do is to create a new instance of a Laravel application project. So UCD into htdocs. And then I will go to laravel.com. And we install a fresh install of Laravel. So under documentation, you scroll up to where we will be installing the project via Composer. I will pause this video and return when the installation is complete. Welcome back. As you can see, our package has installed successfully, so I would like to hop into it. So UCD, it is called Google Login. That is the name of our project. So we are inside. What I would like us to do is to install Socialite. So I will search Socialite under Laravel documentation. And for us to install Socialite, you say Composer require Laravel Socialite. It will take a while to install, so let me pause the video once again. Laravel Socialite is completely installed, so you go to setting it up. I will copy this and declare configuration in config services. So we open our project in Sublime and so go to config and services, then I'll paste what we have copied from there, change this to Google, and change this one to Google also, and this one to Google. I'll copy these two and put them in env. That is the Google client ID and the Google client secret. How you come to handle them later. Next thing is routing, and the first thing I will do is to put this in our login controller, but as of yet we have not been able to generate the auth authentication system. So I will first of all generate the authentication system and then come back. So I will write JavaScript and CSS scaffolding, choose that one. We will install Laravel UI, which has Vue and Bootstrap scaffolding. So I will install that package and force. Laravel UI is installed. The next thing is for me to do Bootstrap and auth scaffolding, that is login and registration. So I will paste this one and run it. It is run. The next thing that you do is to do npm install and npm run dev to compile our assets. I will pause the video. The assets have finished compiling. Now my authentication system is up and running, so I will go back to Socialite. And copy this and paste it in my login app, HTTP controllers auth login controller, just there I paste it and change this to Google. Small letters, this one also to Google, and save. And here, after I have done everything I would want to check, what is being returned from Google, the next thing is to go to the routes folder in web.php and paste those two and change this one also back to Google. And also here I want to change the callback to Google. I would want to take this callback, and let me just delete everything. I don't know what has happened there. Well, let me just paste again. Paste. So this is Google. And this one will also be Google. Then I wanted to copy the callback and go to services. I had not declared that one. So here we have localhost. That is the port that our server is running on. Then I'll paste the callback there. Then I will go to resources, views, login, auth, login.blade, and create a button here. So I will use a tag such that it's a link. Otherwise, if I use a button, then when you click on it, it will be submitting. Then the class, I want it to be BTN. BTN danger. Then I will say login with Google. Of course, you know this one, you are supposed to create that button and use Font Awesome or SVG to style it such that it looks nice. But for the scope of this tutorial, I would like it to be as small as possible, so we will just work with that. So let me run our server. And see how that button is displaying. And even before we do that, we go back to web.php, and the link that we are supposed to follow should be that one. So you go to login.blade and put that as the link, login/Google. Now after that, what I'm going to do is to run the server as I've done and check how the pattern looks. Login, and here we have login with Google. Now I have not been able to get the client ID and client secret both for Google, and so that is the next thing that I would like to do, because currently even if I click on this, my application will fail. So because of that, I will go to console dot developers dot google dot com /APIs. So that is the one that I will follow. Then I'll click on credentials. As you can see, I have nothing here, so I will create credential. And here what we want to create is a auth ID, auth client ID, and it's for a web application. So it has given us options: web application, Android, Chrome, iOS, other. So web application. The name of this client ID, I have called it web client ID 1, just the default that they have given. Then the authorized JavaScript origin, I will do HTTP local host 8000, because I'm testing this one on localhost. Then callback URL, here you go back to services.php and copy everything that we have there. So that is what I place it here. I paste there. Then I'll create. So it has been able to create. Now you can see I have my client ID, so I can copy. Instead of just double clicking there, I can click there and copy, go to my env and paste the client ID, then go back, copy the secret again, go to env and paste the secret, and then save. I need to go back to login controller and say use socialite, import it up there. I believe now I can be able to check if my application is good. So I will click on the button. It's giving us an error. Let me go back and check. So we have been able to change the env, the details on env, and as you can see, we have client ID and client secret. The error that is giving us, let me just log in again. The error is that is giving us is saying missing required parameter, which is client ID. So what I'll do here is to stop my server and start it again, such that not Apache, the web server here, sorry, the web server. I will start it again. PHP artisan serve, it is this one, not Apache and MySQL. So I will start the development server again, and then go back, refresh, and as you can see, we would want to dump and die the user. So I believe when we click on login, then it you bring us, yes, as you can see, it's going on successfully. So I need to choose the account that I will use. So let me use this one here. So it's working, and you can see I have the details, the name, the email, and avatar, among other things. So I think that is successful so far. Now what I would like us to do is to put this user in our database. So the first thing I will do is say user is equals to user, and I have to import user up there. So I will say create first or create. What this one means is that it will check the database to confirm whether the user exists or the details that we want to pass in. If the details exist, it will not create a user. It will not put those details in the database. If not, then the details will be put in the database. So here we want the name. Name, and this one will be user get name like that, the email will be user get email, and I'm not supposed to use a colon, I'm supposed to just use a comma. And then the next thing is that I would want to create, which we have not even done, so is provider ID, which will be given by user get ID. So those are the things that you'll be sending to our database. The next thing I would, so here I will import use app user. The next thing is to log in this user. So you come down here and say oath, login, and the first parameter is user. And the next one is true, such that we will be able to log in this user. Then here we will return redirect, and we will be redirecting this user to home. And since we have created our migrations, I believe everything will work fine. Now I need to go and do changes to the database. So we go to database and go to migrations and click on the create users table. That is the users table. I want to add two things. The first thing, I want to make the password nullable, because Google would have authenticated the user. I don't need to do to it's not a must for them to have a password inserted in the database. And then the next thing here is a provider ID. As you can see, I have underscore ID. You close this. I also want to make it nullable, such that a user who logs in using the normal method will not be asked to have a provider ID. Only the users will be authenticated via third-party applications. So I believe my migrations are good. Now, the next thing, I will go to user.php, the user model. Let me close this one such that I can be able, yes, the user model. And I want to add one more thing here. We also need provider ID, like that. I have saved that. I have not created the, I will go back to env and define my database. So here I would want my database to be called google underscore login, like that. So that is the name of my database. Then the username, you remain as root, and the password as an empty string. So here you go to localhost php myadmin, that there. And since my SQL and Apache is running, so you'll be able to access it, I will say new, and then you create a database called Google Login Create. So that is good enough. The next thing I will do is to exit the server a little and then do the migration. So PHP artisan migrate. If everything is alright, our migrations will be done. So the migrations have been done, and as you can see, we have the users table, the passwords table, password reset, and failed jobs. So if we go to Google Login, we'll be able to see those tables. Now the next thing I would like us to do is to go back to Login Controller, and I would like to, yes, I have already removed the that which we were doing, the dump and die. So our user will be authenticated if all is well, and the user will be redirected to home. So I would like to check and see if everything is okay, and see what we will do. So here I will go back and back again. So where we go to our project, it is not running, so let me run the project, I mean let me run the server, PHP artisan serve. The development server has started. So again, I will refresh. We have a syntax error in Login Controller. So let me go back there and check what is it. Let me see what it says. Expecting yes, this one is a problem. That one is a problem. In fact, is it even necessary? I don't think so, but let us leave it like that. Refresh again. Yes, the error is gone. So that was what was causing us the problem. So again, I would like to click Login with Google. So it will take us to Google. We will choose our account. And then let us wait and see. I have not imported auth. So let us go back here and say use auth. That one. So let me check the database if it has anything so far. Yes, it has one user, so I would like to drop them for now. Okay, like that. So go back go back to our project, refresh, then log in with Google. So it will take us here. I have several emails, so I will choose the one that I would want to use to log in. And as you can see, we are logged in, and this is our name, Prince Cyber and Electronics. Now, if I log out, remember my credentials are already saved in the database. So if I log in again, it will not create the credentials, but it will just go straight ahead and log me in. I believe that is what it's supposed to do. As you can see, I'm logged in again. Now I will log out. Now if somebody comes and registers, let me say the name is James, the email address is maybe that, the password is secret, and like that, and they register. Oh no, the password does not match. Okay, so let me put a different password. I mean, more than 8 characters. So let me see. So if a user logs in, must be at least 8 characters. So when a user logs in using the normal method again, they will be logged in. So this is James. So you can see both the authentication systems, the one that we are using Google and the normal one where a user registers, are all working. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial, and see you next time. Kindly remember to hit the subscribe button and also the notification button, such that you'll be notified when a new useful video is posted. Thank you very much and goodbye.